and welcome to another edition of OGR. Thanks for joining us from the Michigan Audio Lab studio. I'm your host, Mike Abraham. This knucklehead next to me is Eric Van Landingham. How you doing, Eric?
I'm doing great. How you doing?
I'm doing great. Thanks for asking.
Yeah.
So today's episode, we're going to talk about Girlschool by Britny Fox. And what has the singer Dean Davidson got going on in that song? We're going to do the top 10 things that Dean Davidson sounds like doing this song. You remember Britny Fox?
Sounds like to us. Yeah, 80s band. He sang right along the lines of like Cinderella or Brian Johnson from AC/DC, that raspy falsetto.
Yeah, it's horrible.
Yeah, well, he wasn't, in my opinion, quite as good at it as a lot of the other guys.
Right.
I love Cinderella. Tom Kiefer's awesome.
Yeah,
he can sing.
For sure.
This guy, not so much.
I mean, they sold more records than both of us.
They did.
So,
they did.
I mean, we're no.
And
really,
we probably were the ones that bought a couple.
Probably.
You know.
And we're in no position to criticize, but.
Nope.
Then again, yes, we are.
We are.
They don't have a YouTube channel, and we do. So we are going to give you the top 10 things that Dean Davidson sounds like. But before we do that, we want to make mention of these hats that we're wearing. You'll see these hats that we're wearing. They say MI Meats. That's for Mike's Meats at Mike's Meat Market.
Mike's Smoked Meats.
It's formerly Kolaski's Market. It's on the corner of Washburn and Saginaw, which is M38 in Vassar.
Yeah, Mike's Corner Market. And there's also one in just north of Midland.
It's in Crump.
Crump.
Yeah, right in Crump. Mike's Corner Market.
So he's branched out. His meats are so good.
Yeah.
That he's branched out and created and built another one here. And it's great for me because it's right down the street.
Right.
And they've been so nice to supply us with these hats and some of the smoked meats to taste.
Right.
To check out.
And they are fabulous. Even before we had them as a sponsor, we were eating this stuff like every week, right?
We'd buy it before the show.
I would stop in and get them. These things are fabulous. They're so fresh. They taste wonderful. They have all different flavors. What kind you got there?
This is a honey barbecue.
Honey barbecue. I know they have a pizza flavor.
Meat stick.
Can you say that one time?
Meat stick.
Meat stick. I just like watching you say it.
There you go.
Okay, this is just regular meat stick?
Honey barbecue.
That's awesome.
It's awesome. It's very
fresh.
Not dry at all.
No, moist and fresh.
Moist and awesome.
And this one has cheese in it. They also have habanero flavor. And then they got jerky, fabulous jerky. This is the pepper garlic jerky. What do you got over there?
Got a jalapeno jerky.
Awesome.
And I'm a big fan of anything that's spicy, hot. I don't like that red hot vinegary kind of hot. I like jalapeno or Mexican food type of hot. And this, I can tell you right now, is gonna be awesome.
What's the flavor again?
Jalapeno.
Mmm.
Again, moist, fresh.
Mm.
Killer.
Jerky, smokes meats, Mike's Meat, Mike's Smoked Meats at Mike's Meat Market.
They also have Great Crown Apple there. Always in stock.
They make a mean pint of Crown Apple there as well.
And like you said, it used to be called Kolaski's Market, and the owner was Junior Kolaski, and he ran the thing for as long. I mean, I've been around this area since the early 90s, and he was always there. And when you would go to the store, everybody that came into that store was greeted with Junior Kolaski saying, "Beautiful day." I mean, there could be a tornado going through, mm-hmm. and he would say it was a beautiful day.
Mm-hmm.
And Mike's has adopted that saying and keeps it alive in the memory of Junior Kolaski.
Well, one
awesome.
They have incredible meat products. They have a full meat counter there as well, too. You can get hand-cut steaks there.
Yep.
And it's Mike's Meat Market.
No, Mike's Smokes Corner
meat.
Market.
Mike's Corner Market. Mike's Smokes Meats. Be sure to check it out on the corner of Washburn and Saginaw, which is M38 in Vassar.
38, yep.
Speaking of meat. We lost, the music world lost Meatloaf this month. And, you know, quite a loss, really, when you look at his total body of work and what he meant to music.
Right.
And we're going to do a shot of Crown Apple that we bought at Mike's Corner Market.
When you know that Meatloaf, he was a great singer, he had a great band, but he died, so 2 out of 3 ain't bad.
Oh, man, that's bad. That's terrible. That's horrible.
Too soon.
You know, I would do anything. For a meat stick.
But I won't do that. All right.
So we are going to do a shot in honor of the esteemed Mr. Loaf, who passed away today. And if you're like me and you went and looked up some of his old videos, you've got to be impressed with just the theatrical, the thing that he did, the operatic thing. And him and his band, they were so intense. I remember the Bat Out of Hell album you know, being a kid and thinking that was the coolest album. I was like, oh, there's got to be some evil stuff on here. But
yeah, me too. But then you listen to it, and it's not.
Of course, there wasn't any evil stuff on there.
It looked cooler than it was.
It did.
But now that I'm older and I understand where he was going, the theatrics.
Yeah.
And I like it a lot better now.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, he was awesome, though, with the handkerchief and the sweat and the hair flying. I mean, just timeless, really awesome
stuff. Yeah, he
was
a cool dude.
And very, very sad that he passed away. And
so here's to the esteemed Mr. Loaf.
The esteemed Mr. Loaf. Rest in peace.
Yum. All right, let's move along to our
list. I like
it. All
right.
I think we should.
So now, Girls School by Britny Fox. Let's give it a listen. Pull it up and let them hear it. This is what we're talking about.
What this sounds like.
Tell me what you think the singer sounds like. Be sure to send us an email at oldguysrockin@gmail.com.
Sequencia, look for emails from these people that
put up the link. You can send us an email and tell us what you think, and maybe we'll add that to a future episode. So let's hear the clip of the song.
Here we go.
Okay, that's enough. Yeah. Yeah, you guys remember that song? I think this guy's voice sounds like two seagulls fighting over a chicken bone at the beach.
And I've heard that sound before.
Yeah. Asshole! Mine!
Right, mine. You've seen that cartoon. Okay, so I'm going to say Dean Davidson's voice to me sounds like Bon Scott sleeping on his back. Too soon for that one?
Too soon. All right. This guy's voice sounds like a snare roll on Saint Anger.
Oh, says James.
Take that, Lars.
Sorry about that, Lars. Gilbert Gottfried on Estrogen. Is that even funny?
Oh, I don't know. Yeah, I think that's about right. No, I think this guy's voice sounds like Edith Bunker having an orgasm.
Yes! Now that's funny.
Oh, watch it at the girls' school!
That's a good one.
What else you got?
Right there. Udo Dirkschneider with a longer neck. He's the singer for Accept, who also had this style of singing going on, and quite likely is even worse than Dean Davidson.
I love Udo. You don't like Udo?
I love Accept, but
awesome.
Man, he was voted the worst singer in rock and roll.
Well, that's terrible.
Like a bunch of years in a row.
Well, that's terrible, because this guy's way worse than Udo.
No, I don't know, man.
Udo Dirkschneider's the man. You ever seen him live? He sounds just as terrible. So,
it's hard to duplicate that horridness.
Yeah. So, the next one on my list is, this guy's voice sounds like Fran Drescher getting a pap smear. With an ice cold speculum.
Ooh. And she's got the most unique, nasty voice, man.
Oh, it's horrible.
Yeah.
It's horrible. She could probably sing this song and pull it off.
She could probably pull this song off. I got Tom Kiefer, if Tom Kiefer sucked. That's what this guy sounds like.
This guy sounds like Tom Kiefer.
If Tom Kiefer sucked. And if you don't know who Tom Kiefer is, he's the singer of Cinderella. Don't know what you got till
you know. I could be mistaken, but I think Britney Fox actually came before Cinderella.
Did they?
I believe they did. Like, he had this vocal thing going on so that when we heard Cinderella, it didn't sound so foreign and icky to us. Like you said, he's much better. You know, Kiefer's much better than this guy. So
I was never a Cinderella fan. They were a little light and pink
poppy,
and fluffy for
poppy,
me.
Yeah.
But I saw them probably 10 years ago, and they nailed it. That dude can sing, man.
Yeah, oh yeah, Tom Kiefer's killer.
He can sing.
I seen
plays
him back
the
in freaking the day.
Grand piano. He's awesome.
Yeah, I seen him back Cinderella in the day opening for David Lee Roth. They were great live.
Yeah, they
so,
were awesome.
Yeah, Tom Kiefer sucked. That's a good one. next thing on my list is this guy's voice sounds like he's getting a prostate exam from Freddy Krueger. You better make it three.
That'd be a toughie. Right there, it'd be a toughie. Here's your help.
You got anything else on your
list?
I'll
cheer you for that one.
All right. You got anything else on your list?
Yeah, I got one more.
Let's hear it.
Dean Davidson from Britney Fox sounds like Brian Johnson with appendicitis.
I can hear that. I can actually hear that.
Yeah.
Interesting fun fact.
Ooh!
Fun fact.
Ow!
Yeah. Fun fact, Brian Johnson had appendicitis, and AC/DC was in the crowd and watched him play that. Now, this is a true story. He was rolling around on the ground in pain and agony, still trying to sing the songs, and they thought he was the greatest thing. Bon Scott said, if anything ever happens to me, that's the guy I want you to get. Yeah. Sure enough. They
wish is my command.
Yeah, one of the greatest second front men ever. So,
all right.
So here's to Britny Fox, and here's to you all for watching us. And here's to Mike's.
If Dean Davidson is watching, just take it with a grain of salt, buddy. Right. It's just a joke.
If Dean Davidson's watching, we'd love you to come on our show and rip on us all
rip
night.
On
that
us.
Would be absolutely fine.
Tell us how bad we suck.
So we'd like to thank Mike's Corner Market for the hats and awesome beef jerky and meat sticks. Be sure to check them out on the corner of Washburn and Saginaw, which is M38. Thanks for tuning into this episode of OGR. Peace.